30 years ago this year, I travelled to Kenya and Somalia with Sally O'Neill of Trokra. Trokra were working in cooperation with the elders on a seeds and wells programme in Gedo province of Somalia that is just across from the large Mandera refugee camp. We began in Mandera, where there were 50,000 people. Our trip ended after 8 days in Baidoa, where 250 people a day were dying. Known as the City of Death, we saw it firsthand, the famine's impact on a highly vulnerable population dying from lack of food and water. That visit deeply moved me and left a lasting impression. As I left Somalia, Mogadishu Airport, President Mary Robinson was arriving. She was responding to a request from Trokra concerning Gol, and she would go on to give an interview from Mandera refugee camp that was as heartbreaking as it was enraging. She immediately left for the United Nations in New York to tell of what she saw. The response of the international community to what she described was that it must be never again. Last Sunday, when I spoke to Abir Rashid Haji of Concern, he told me of women who were lighting fires with no food to keep cook, lighting fires just to keep the children's hopes up that there might be food. After the visit of 1992, 20 years, in 2011, Mary Robinson travelled again to the region with Irish development agencies to sound the alarm on another devastating hunger crisis unfolding in the region. At that stage, the United Nations were reporting that over 13 million people across Ethiopia, Kenya, and Somalia were at risk due to one of the worst droughts to strike the region in 60 years. As a result of a delayed global response, the 2011 famine claimed the lives of more than 260,000 people in Somalia. Half of them were children under five. Once again, the international community's response was, it must be never again. Now, a decade later, in 2022, the region is facing yet another grave hunger crisis. It differs for Somalians in that there is not a neighboring country now to which one might flee. The drought, the worst in decades, has affected the entire region. The catastrophic famine, and it is that, which now threatens the entire region, is one of huge proportions. One person is likely to be dying of hunger now every 48 seconds in drought-ravaged Ethiopia, Kenya, and Somalia in the Horn of Africa. According to recent estimates in a report by Oxfam and Save the Children, that report states that the number of people experiencing extreme hunger in these countries has more than doubled since last year, from over 10 million to more than 23 million today, with nearly 500,000 people in parts of Somalia and Ethiopia facing famine-like conditions. Children are affected, and the United Nations has warned that in Somalia alone, up to 350,000 children may die unless action is taken, and taken now. This is what is unfolding as I speak, already being called the greatest humanitarian crisis since the Second World War. The growing impact of climate change, compounded by conflict and the fallout from COVID-19, and the unparalleled period of drought, has devastated crops and destroyed livelihoods, forcing millions of people to leave their homes. The numbers displaced globally has now surpassed the 100 million threshold, for the first time since record keeping began. The war in Ukraine has also impacted. Food and fuel prices have already increased. Basic food prices have risen 100% since January. Where understandably our attention has been deflected from other global crises onto the site of the war and the suffering of brave Ukrainian people, its consequences for the most threatened in Africa cannot afford to be ignored. The reality is that countries in the global south who have contributed least to climate change are suffering the most from a combination of our current crises. They are carrying immediate and terrible consequences reflected in the images we are seeing coming from the Horn of Africa in recent months. Images of malnourished children, dead animals strewn across burnt sands, families on the move, and people yet again on the verge of famine. As to climate change and its consequences, rich and industrialized countries have contributed around 92% of excess historical emissions and 37% of current emissions, whereas Africa's current emissions stand at just 4%. The collective carbon emissions of Somalia, Ethiopia, and Kenya, who represent 2.5% of the world's population, is 0.1% of the global total. We as a nation and the global community cannot avert our gaze. We have a moral and ethical responsibility as a country that has historically known terrible deprivation and hunger ourselves to reach out and support our brothers and sisters in need. Hunger represents the grossest of human rights violations and one of the greatest ethical challenges facing the world today. We urgently need a renewed effort to help prevent the deaths of millions of poor and marginalized people. As a matter of extreme urgency, the international community needs to make the funds required available to stave off a pending humanitarian disaster and to get immediate aid to people who are starving in Africa. The United Nations estimates that humanitarian funding of $4.4 billion is required to provide the life-saving assistance and protection in the region. To date, the appeal is drastically underfunded. The international community must ensure that commitments on climate change and sustainable development are turned into funded and implementable policies and actions. What is required is a robust regulatory framework which protects our fragile and threatened environment and which also respects the right of small landholders to remain on their land and retain access to water resources. The international community is challenged by this threatened famine and all famines to honour its obligations to climate change adaptation. It was heartening recently to see DOCUS as part of an Irish network of international development and humanitarian organisations, to which 54 organisations are affiliated, raise awareness of this crisis with a powerful briefing for politicians and media. I thank them for all the valuable work they are doing, the facts they are putting before us. Such detail on the fragility of food systems, including the looming tragedy that might come from East Africa as a result of its dependence for its wheat on Ukraine and Russia. Dependence that goes over 90%. Irish humanitarian organisations, missionaries and the Irish government through Irish Aid have for many years been providing highly effective assistance to millions of people across the Horn of Africa region, as well as other parts of the world. The reputation of the Irish in the region is immense, based on our track record of practical solidarity, and not just words. That this support is maintained and increased is now more important than ever. The late Sally O'Neill, my friend, was a Throchra stalwart who for over three decades dedicated her life to defending on several continents the human rights of people living in poverty. Her spirit lives on in the hundreds of Irish Aid agency staff who are working on the front line, transforming lives of millions every day. As President of Ireland, Máirc Throna Héireann, I salute them for their passion and dedication and offer them solidarity too. Let us be in no doubt that the starvation of famine now faced on such a more dangerous level is as much a political failure today as it was when President Mary Robinson, Sally O'Neill and I visited Somalia in 1992, and when President Mary Robinson visited the country again in 2011. Famine in the Horn of Africa is showing us so clearly and tragically as how all of our current global crises are connected, and that connection must be recognised. For example, the war in Ukraine has had a serious impact on food insecurity in the region of which I speak. Wheat and wheat products account for 1/3 of the average national cereal consumption. Regionally, 84%. In the case of Somalia, it is 92% of that demand is met by imports from Russia and Ukraine. We cannot let famine in the Horn of Africa slip down and off the agenda of those who have most to give, such as the participants at the G7. Smaller countries have been giving a lead in response to the tragically very poorly supported $4.6 billion needed now. For example, Ireland is the 7th largest contributor to the United Nations Central Emergency Response Fund. It is a global catastrophe which threatens, indeed which has arrived. A global response is needed now if our words of before, it must be never again, are to carry the ring of authenticity. Each day of delay on action is costing lives. Globally, we have the capacity to anticipate and prevent regional and global famines. Give meaning to those words, never again. The transformation we need is possible, is overdue. This crisis requires an immediate response from all of us in the global community. Thank you.